certain kind of repetition can be done. Like probably you have this kind of comment lines is also there. Other than this number sign, this comment line is called doc string comment. Three triple quotes, double quotes or triple quotes. Remember, double quotes and single quote are equivalent in Python. My suggestion is use for single quote. Or whether you use it single quote, you always use single quote. Do not mix single quote and double quote. All equivalent. Okay. So three triple quotes and whatever this, it's a comment line. And any def function call or in a class, you can put this comment line for debugging. This quote ends into the that PyPyC file, which will run. So this is also a comment line, but this comment line is separate from this comment line. This comment line is taken out of the code whenever it is running, and this comment line as a put as a comment line in within the code, so that any module is problematic, you can get it debugged from this. This is called doc string comment. We'll show it. See, you have all done this. I'm a little bit of revision all this thing. This is the casting operator. This thing casting is very prevalent in Java also, in everywhere casting. Where is the casting is required? I have told you the Python is a dynamic type. Python variable is dynamic type, whereas C and Java variable is static type. What is the difference between static type and dynamic type? Whenever you are C, you have to declare each and every variable, and before compiling you have to decide whether it is integer, float, character. And in Java, in Python you need not to be, but in Java also you have to declare integer, float and all this. This is called static type. There are some various advantages of static typing and dynamic typing, because mainly C is compiler driven and Python is interpreter driven. And static typing advantage is lot of error can be corrected at the pre-compiling stage, but the disadvantage is whenever it is running as intermediate code, I have told you again and again, Python is basically code on multi-platform, multi-computer, simultaneous use and all these things. It is the code cannot be run, it can be run on a monolithic computer, but on your desktop computer, but it can be run as a distributed system also. That is the main purpose, because we know that we do not have a single big computer nowadays. We have every person's, you are aware of what not, every person's have 4 or 5 computers, 6 computers are at your home, maybe at washing machine, maybe your microwave oven, at your car. Definitely there's some, if a modern car, there are around 18 chips are there, say even any basic Maruti car right now, maybe 18 computer chips. You know there is shortage of computer chips, because everywhere the computer chips is there for anything, in smartphone definitely, where we are right now. It is so, even it is not sure that your code will be run in your PC, and then C is the best. But whenever you are not sure this, it could be run on a virtual machine, there are two, three alternatives are there. Most popular is Java virtual machine. It runs on everywhere, and also Python virtual machines. It can run on everywhere. So the variables can be, again, I'm coming back, what is a variable? Variable can be static type and or dynamic type, static C, Java static type. So everything you have to declare earlier. The programming compiler, after compilation there will be less errors, but in Python it is need not to be. That is the chance of Python codes can have some errors, but you declare a variable, you do not have to declare a variable. Variable take the type of its content, that is called dynamic. But once it is dynamic, but you cannot put it to integer once again, so it is a strong type. Once it is, though it is dynamic, but it is not a weak. Weak means, but if you go PHP, there's another language that is, it is a dynamic and weak. That means anything can be put onto this. So here you have to casting. You have to knowingly casting it. If it's integer, you have to put it in a floating point, you have to casting it. So like here, we have your casting. Yeah, it is a 3 is an integer, and you are casting with a string operator. But in the PHP, the another very popular language, you don't need, automatically string will be, x will be 3. But that is the reason, Python, though it is dynamic, but it is a strong type. Like here, see 3 is an integer, now it's a float, this is a casting operator. And you can check whether it is done or not, you can write it print type, then it will, you know, the Python will declare whether it is integer, float, and all this. Incidentally, Python doesn't have character, I have told last class. Python has one great advantage, you can declare, you can initialize all the variables at a time, and you can declare it, you can see it. Now, let's see certain things. This is, if you run it, it will be, let's check, what is this? Yeah, it is -2. Can you tell me, can anybody, it is the most negative version. It is, if it is a, if it is a +3, say I call it a +3, it will be 1, but it will be, if it is a -3, ideally it should be -1, it is not, it is more negative. So it is, that is the convention. Like here, is a -5, it will be -3, but if it is a +5, it will be 2. So remainder is 1, but it's a -5. You cannot take the -2. It is more negative, rounding to the more negative. So this is the double means. Here you see print 10 by 3, like it is automatically give the this number. Here you can see print 10 minus 3. It is a -1. Like it is, it should be -3.33, but we are rounding at a negative sign, so result will be this, because you are, it's a negative number. I think these I have covered in earlier class, so let's begin certain new thing here today. All this frozen set, you know that the set is frozen. Freeze the list, I can show it here. Yeah, histogram, I want to show it here. Here what I see, letter counts is a set. And remember, whenever you say second bracket opening, second bracket end, it can be set also, it can be dictionary. But whenever you have put nothing into it, it is a dictionary. So remember, it is a dictionary. So then this is a letter for letter in Mississippi, letter counts letter, and letter counts got greater +1. If you do it, say M comes 1, I comes 4 times, Mississippi, S comes 4 times, P comes 2. So this is it. Or you can change it, say our, say BPPIMT, say BPPIMT 202, okay, BPPIMT CAC, CAC. Let's see what is the count. Yeah, B comes once, B comes one, B, 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 B comes two, I once, A once, like this. Now it's a dictionary. Okay, this is a kind of a call histogram also. How many characters are there? And this is, you all know, let's see. This is interesting. Last day, I am not sure whether I have done it or not. Yeah, this is again, I am object oriented programming, where we have, last day we have class encapsulation. First thing is encapsulation and abstraction. Same word, abstraction and encapsulation. You are your real life object, you make a, but if it is too many real life object, then you see the commonality and you make abstract class, parent class, and derive the child class. That is called inheritance. The first thing, abstraction and encapsulation goes together, and then comes your derived class, like teacher, student. So here I have declared a class. Class is a keyword, and it is a dog, and it is a class variable, kind canine, and this is a constructor, underscore underscore self name. you now the this is a class definition is over. Now you initialize a variable and you instantiate object out of it and give the name Fido. Fido is the name of the dog, and you print it, whatever it is, and E, and another time E, another dog you call is a bunny, yeah, bunny, and then print E and a name, and it is the output. It is objects, it is automatically Python, so it is an object, and Fido is name and bunny. And try this code. We just copied the code yesterday. I showed it how to run it in PyCharm. So everybody install please PyCharm on your Windows 10 or Linux. You go to the PyCharm site, community edition, you download it and just run it. So I'm just copy that code, this same code I run, hopefully it will run. Yeah, it is running great. So it is faster. So I practice both PyLab, PyDiff, PyPy, there is Anaconda, there are various utilities. Main advantage of IDEs is it will help you. Okay, so I think you have got it there. So let's go back to my original code again. So that day, yesterday, this portion I'm not shown to this. Yeah, this is also I've shown you. Yeah, last day. This report detail I wish to show you. This is a parent class. Let's see. Yeah, class dog. Yeah, it is a object-oriented programming. It's same class dog. Species is a class variable. This is a constructor, name and age. This is a description. This is format, it is return self name and age, instance method. Another method is the two method, one is description and another is speak, return what is the sound. Then another Russell carrier, that is another derived class. Base class is dog and it run, it I am overriding. Somebody asked yesterday what is overriding. Overriding means if it is a base class, certain things are definition are there. But in a derived class, you can derive, you can have a different interpretation, and that will run, not the base class one. So that is the overriding. That is overriding, and whenever within the class, it is overloading. I will tell you what is the difference between overriding and overloading in object-oriented programming. Overriding means if it is a method in the base class, you run it differently in your derived class. That is overriding. This is overriding, and child class inherit attribute and behaviors. Then another Jim is a bulldog. Bulldog is a come to Jim. Print Jim description, child class specific attributes, child class attribute, and Jim is. This is a coding run. I just check whether this code, I have not yet checked whether the code run. It should run in our more here. What we have done here, another utility that Colab also. This is a different color. That is the advantage of using the ID. Different color. This is a, like it's a keyword. Yeah. This is initializer. Everything comment is there. So this is a. I am creating another class, Russell Terrier. And in Java, I told you that is a definition. It's called in Java. It will be Russell Terrier extends dog. Okay. And C plus plus. Another different way. So it is not Java, it is Python. I found this is much more compact, and this is the method. Okay, this is a pandas. One is what is NumPy? NumPy is a array, basically C array. You think of it C array, but it's much more powerful than C array. It is a multi-dimensional. And you can like it is with more. You can think of a how you can see malloc and galloc. You can take it as a galloc, so that you can chunk of memory the NumPy. And not only that, you can have maxima, minima, all these things can be done. But NumPy, one disadvantage is whenever in machine learning, you have to have more, like, you have to take, there are a lot of data that are generating. Right now, I am also creating data, you are creating data, you are in your Gmail or something, and you are clicking it here, clicking it there. So lots of data is being generated, and it's scraped by Google or Facebook or WhatsApp, and they do put the data to Google. Is always said, I am putting the data in your Google map, put to various advertising agencies. So they have a chunks of data, petabyte order, terabyte order data, and these data cannot be, sometimes data is missing, sometimes connection is off. Data generally can be put in a Excel table. But the thing, Excel table like sort of thing, and there are certain rows may be missing, certain columns may be missing, these kind of data, that all these things can happen. This cannot be put into NPRA. So there are another utility that is called Pandas. So Pandas is very helpful to put this kind of data and taking the machine learning, because Python is main for machine learning. So Pandas is built on NumPy, but it has more statistical feature, it can have a more larger things and all this. So I just importing Pandas, I'll go details Pandas later. So this is, I am import NumPy, that I have NumPy you already know. This is, I have a matplotlib, which is a, I have told you what is matplotlib. Matplotlib is nothing but, there is a, another big good, very good software company, is world, one of the top five software companies, that's called MATLAB, that is called MATLAB. It is for those who are in electronics and electrical of your first year, second year student, they must be introduced MATLAB in their electric engineering lab, electronics lab, because in MATLAB, a lot of mathematics can be very easy. I mean, you don't have to type too much, but Python is catching up. Python is, MATLAB is costly, license, and Python has made a copy, more or less a clone version of MATLAB, and call this a matplotlib. And see, we are a data, we are generating huge amount of data with this random and all this, you generate a histogram out of it. I just show it and then I go to another matplotlib. Anyway, you can see that, run the data, you just don't have to understand everything. I just say Pandas is a PD, that you know, NumPy, you print NP, and matplotlib as a plot, okay, and classic data. And this is, you take a np.random, you are generating random data, and these are the range, 2000 points, and data frame. I told you what is the data frame. Pandas is a data frame, and each column is a series. So if you run this, yeah, it is the output. Let's try this code. Another thing, plot.show should be there. Yeah, it is running, and if you just copy this section, copy this and run it our PyCharm, because it is running on desktop, it will be run on your desktop, it will not on Colab, and it is much faster. You should try this. So if you run here, yeah, it is running good. So this is a graphs, you can any graph, and you can do it with matplotlib. It is a histogram. We are generating some random data and putting it to histogram with a range. Okay, so code, you have to calculate time, how much time and what is the start time, and you want to run the your operating system code within your program, and it's a threading concept is there. In C, there is no threading concept. C is one particular process running like a bull. It cannot divide and conquer policy, it cannot, but Java and Python, but because it is running on Python virtual machine or Java virtual machine, it can a particular process can subdivide its work, is a divide and conquer by thread, because most of the CPU right now, we have a multiple CPU, we have a quad core, octa core, so C is a definite disadvantage there. Then we should go for C++, but again C++ doesn't have this threading facility. So though C runs faster on a, but C taken as a computer, as a single computer, But Python and Java, they take it as one virtual machine. So the concept of threading is it is a mini process. A process can trigger multiple threads and appears to run faster. Say you are running a Word program in your Windows, and you have to open up multiple documents. In one document you are spell checking, one document you are formatting, one document you are saving as a PDF file. And if it is your operating system doesn't support threading, but most of the operating system right now supports threading, so that is a virtual machine supports threading. If it's a theoretical case, if it is not support threading, then the Word program is finish one program at a time, then go to another program. One program, or it appears to be very slow. It is time tasking is there, but slicing is there, but it appears to be slow, though the computer is running very fast. So that is the concept that threading comes. Threading comes means a process can generate multiple thread, and it gives allocates time. The thread becomes active maybe only for 10 milliseconds or 5 milliseconds, but it appears to be faster. Actually, job is little less. It can be done in 1 or 2 milliseconds, but it gives the user feedback much more. Anyway, so that is a threading concept in Python is there. So here I am seeing the idea process running main program is 59, main program thread and main thread. Those who are working on Java, you know Java is also main thread is working. Let's try this code to run it down our PyCharm. Anyone? Any noise is coming? Can you mute your microphone all, please? Thank you. Please mute all your microphone. Some noise is coming. Can anybody tell me who is? Everyone, mic off, please. Thank you. Yeah, so you run the code. Yeah, it is running. So it is, but the idea of the, it might change. It depends on the implementation of the Python virtual machine. So number should be changed. Even if my personal computer number will be changed, but the code, same code is running. So what I want to impress upon you today, that the code which is running on Colab, it can be the same code without changing anything. It can be run on your Python machine, and it should be, it should work with the IDE, not the bare Python compiler. Choose your ID, and so that is the impression today. Another thing I need to show. So this is it. Another thing, say another code. I'll explain the code. This is, I'm using the Matplotlib. I just run the code, then it will be interesting. Yeah, it is a particular graph is printing. What is basically this is the first thing is very easy. It's I'm importing Matplotlib as MPL. I'm which version? I'm declaring it with the format string NumPy. I am declaring which version. This is good. And another way you can declare version, one is that way, another is within this is plus string, like casting this. The NP.dot version is a number, I'm casting it. So two way, I prefer this way. So I have shown you it can be done. This print is there for making a blank line. Okay, so I am creating by np line space command. I can creating -5 to 500 such points. This is the command line np the import numpy, then I am creating generating x points from range -5 to +5 and 100 such points. If shape is linear and red, and this is I am plotting a quadratic function x square x to the power 2, and shape is exponential, and then I title and I'm running the plot, the matplotlib. So let's see what is the plotting is coming. Yeah, so it is a linear is coming. So, and if we run the code of the selection to here in our PyCharm, can show the code what is I've done here. Same thing I'm repeating matplotlib, and I am just what is an MPL version. I prefer you always do anything you import, you always print it for your debugging, that at least the code is running and which version. Say version is here better. Colab is giving the older version. So import bracket plot np version, both way I have shown you, and this is a title and I am generating the code. Yeah, it should run. I am making run, run main. Yeah, the same thing, the code is coming. This is x and y and this is a linear on this screen. Okay, so I am going there. Then another code I will show you here. First see the code, then it will be much more interesting. It is a curve is coming because I am again print an MPO version, Excel NP range. I am creating a grid of point NPA range with 0.01 difference minus 2 to 1. Y well cos. I am taking this a cos function. X wells cos function. Y well. Then I am plot and plot dot show. This is a cost function basically. Then let's see, this is a code. So hope so it will run. If I copy selection, if it is non run, I have to check. It will check. Yeah, it is running. So Colab is also running, PyCharm is running, another two class I'll show you, Eclipse. Eclipse is one of the best, and with PyDev, I have to show this code will be running, so we don't have to change the code. That is the great of the Python, it can run anywhere, everywhere. So this is another interesting is, see this code, I'll explain this code. This is straight line, nothing interesting. It is a 2x by 3 something. Let's see some interesting. This is interesting. Oh, great. This is a 3-dimensional. This is a grade of Python. That is the reason we are learning Python. See what we are doing it here. It is import NumPy. Okay, find np version, matplotlib, pandas. I have taken the pandas frame, panda version. Okay, then import a 3-axis, axis 3D is one library there, nothing but. I am figure 1, I am just figure the template, and I am taking a value, x values minus 4 to 4 with 0.25 defining x, and y is np range minus 4 to 4, 0.2 defining y. Then I get mesh grid. This is the np command, np dot mesh grid. This is a particular np utility, and I am generating x, capital X capital Y with mesh grid. And I make an R function with a squared here, making a square. So that is a square function, that is a Z, is a basically sine function. Okay, now I am putting, now I plot surface plot, I have a contour plot, and X, Y, Z, and this is a color, this thing. This, you don't have to go very details, but you should be aware of it. And I am giving the plot show command. This is the thing is coming, the X, Y, Z, X, Y, Z are there, some quadratic function, beautiful picture is coming. I am just checking this, whether this code can run on PyCharm as well. So go there, just delete everything there, control paste. If we don't give plot.show, it will not. That I can guarantee. So run. Yeah, it is running beautifully, and the graph is much better than Colab. So this is, and you can view it, you can round it. That is visualizing the Python is the best. So nobody can compare. Only R is there. You can visualize it various ways. How is the graph, and you can, that is a 3-dimensional graph and all this. And this is a simple code. It is there. I want this kind of project. If you can take it, that will be nice. Let's see what else we can do here. See Colab, one disadvantage is it doesn't give this I have to check the whether that is like PyCharm. It is I can rotate, that is much better. So that is the reason we will go to PyCharm or PyDev. There is another code. This is not very multi-plot basically. I'm not. It is very easy. One thing I want to show. These things not that very interesting. This graph is done by not Matplotlib. It is by SNS. What is this? Another Matplotlib also used and input NumPy, input pandas, and input seaborn. This is the utility. Seaborn is another free utility. It's developed after Matplotlib. It is somehow better than Matplotlib. I have introduced SNS.set. I am generating a random number and I am generating x range of points 0 to 10 within 0, max minimum 0, maximum 10. Without touching 10, I am generating 500 points and I am running this code. And this is the code is running and this graph. This graph, let's see this graph in PyCharm here. Yes, that is, I go there. I run this later in Colab. So that is the reason Colab is not always good. So here, graphs is much more visible that I've told you. This is one. And this is okay. Now, today I summarize what we have done today. First, we start with the very basic of Python, and we shown you the casting operator. The Python variable is the dynamic, unlike C and Java, but it is a strong type, unlike PHP. In C, whatever you know, Java, it is static. Declare it before compile time, but and it is also strong, that is, you cannot put anything and anything on C. But Python, it is a dynamic, it will take the shape of the within the contents, like in liquid, as per the content, it will take the variables. Once it is done, then it is strong. Okay, it's meant for a different language altogether, it is not a replacement of your C or Java. This is a Python is basically for game development, and so you can always make a game development is most welcome. So I think some of you have done tic-tac-toe, is absolutely okay, but if you can much better than tic-tac-toe. One interesting thing I have heard that you are going for bot, that's great. So that's the thing, and Python is actually meant for this, where C cannot and Java cannot process, because whenever you write a program on your machine, that's a program, but whenever at the CPU, program is not running. If you say program is not running, if your program is converted by compiling and linking, it will be a task. If the task is running, okay, single task is running. In C, you a single and a task, and sometimes a process, one particular process is running. Now C cannot divide the various process in a C program, but Java Python, a single process can generate thread. The thread are sharing the same, and they are childs of mother thread. But when the mother thread dies, unlike human, mother thread dies, daughters can be living. But here, no. When the mother thread will die, all the daughter thread also die. So what the things are, daughter thread, the mother thread create good thread, and the threads can divide and conquer policy. The data, the various thread can take different portion of the data at different CPU also, because we have a multi-core CPU. That is the C, Python will be faster on machine where C cannot. C, Python and Java can take this advantage. So thread is basically a mini task or mini process. Okay, so program you write in C coding, that is a program, and then you make a compile with a dot out or GCC. A dot out, and whenever a dot out is running, we call a process, same thing as a Python, but the advantage of Python and Java, it can create thread, that there will be one main thread, that the main thread is in concept is Java same, actually probably Java is born after Python, Python is 89, 90. Main thread can...
So we have done a COVID tracker.
Okay.
So let me first run the code.
Which ID?
I'm using PyCharm.
Great. PyCharm, okay, is great. So, I am also using, yeah.
So, okay, so here this is the window which we have created. This is showing the total number of cases currently,
okay,
the deaths and the recovered.
Yeah.
And here in the here in this we enter the number the name of a country.
Okay.
The first is India. Yes. We go for get data.
Very good.
Take a bit of time. And showing the number of cases currently in India, deaths and recovered.
Okay.
You can use it for any country.
Very good. So, okay. This is excellent. Anything, what is the plan of extension? It's an excellent project. And can you show the code?
Yeah. So this is the code. First we have imported the required packages. Okay, we have inputted requests VS4 Tinker as the Tinker for our graphic user interface so that we can create
Great.
A window and operate within it.
Great.
And we have used time and dateline as an also as input.
Okay.
Then we have used different three functions we have used.
Okay.
One for getting the URL of the website.
Okay.
Then we have used the official website for COVID Worldometer coronavirus. In fact, we can even check the website if we check this web link
okay.
in Google.
Good, good.
This is for the whole whole world for first one, and
Very
this is for the country. And then we are creating in this part. We are creating the window, and we are creating the buttons and operating over it.
Excellent. Thank you.
Okay.
Great work. Carry on.